morning, BHS. It is Friday, October 23rd, and it is National Mole Day. Not Noel Day. It's National Mole Day, like M-O-L-E, the small little animal. Man, everyone gets a day these days, I guess. Every animal, everybody gets a day. When's my day? When is it going to be National Noel Day? I'm waiting. So we'll see. Maybe I guess that's my birthday. Anyway, enough about me. Today, I want to thank Aurora Butler. She is the student that recommended the song Clouds that you heard as part of the intro. Aurora is doing pretty good with her song choices. I'm really appreciative of her. I really like the song. I would have never even heard of it if she hadn't recommended it. So thanks a lot, Aurora. Good stuff. Today in history, back in 2001, Apple announced the production of the first iPod, not iPad, iPod. It's funny because I can't believe how long ago that was. That was almost 20 years ago. And some of you may not even know what iPods were back in the day. Now, since so much of your music is connected just to your regular phones. But I had one of the original iPods. I forgot to bring it today because I was going to show it to you because I'm sure people would be like, what is that device that Mr. Green has? But yeah, so I had one of the original. So thank you, Apple, for that. Just a few announcements today. You're going to send you off into the weekend. I'm hoping you have a great weekend. It's a warm day today, and hopefully it'll hold out through the weekend. I want to say good luck to the sports teams. There's lots of action today. Many teams are playing, including field hockey, who has their second playoff game at 3:30 at Bell's Falls. So if you know one of the players on the team, wish them luck, and I know that they'll do well. Next, today for college visits at the 12 o'clock spot, we have representatives from Franklin Pierce University, Lees McRae, and Williams College. So if you're interested in talking to any of those folks, join in. I'm really excited about the college visits for Monday because a representative from the college that I went to will be there, Grinnell College in Grinnell, Iowa. So I'm actually going to stop in on that one. Next, the GSA, Gay Straight Alliance group. There's a meeting today at 3:30 at One Community Center. So if you want to attend that, it's at One Community Center at 3:30. Let's see. Trivia from yesterday. I thought that I was going to fool students with my trick question. It didn't work. You guys were on it like that. The answer was take the S off of the word seven, and there you go with even. And the winner, again, for the second time, Greta Kilburn. She was on it. She answered pretty quickly. So congratulations, Greta. You are on a roll. All right. I have two more things for today. As I said, today is going to be a little brief. Two more things. One, two lies and a truth for Mr. Green. So another opportunity to weigh in about what you think you may know about Mr. Green, your principal. Two lies and a truth. So here are the three things. You have to determine which one of them is the truth. Statement one, Mr. Green once traveled with Reverend Jesse Jackson. Statement two, Mr. Green was born in Washington, D.C. And statement three, Mr. Green has both of his ears pierced. Which one of those statements is true? Because two of them are not true. So email me to let me know. And lastly, I have a video clip that is going to be attached to this production today. And it's about a very inspirational math teacher. Although he died several years ago, there's a news clip that I want you to watch for a variety of reasons. One, this man was an amazing math teacher in a tough area of East Los Angeles. And he inspired many students. And his life inspired the movie Stand and Deliver, which is one of my favorite movies about education. It's rated PG, so I would highly recommend if you have some time to watch the movie. It's about some students who embark on a math journey. It's a very inspirational movie. It's inspirational for a couple of reasons. One, it really highlights the dedication that teachers have towards their students. And I bring that up because the teachers at BHS are tremendously dedicated to their craft, to you, to the community. So I really praise teachers in this regard. But the movie is also about believing in yourself and not having anyone put doubts in your head about what you can do and what you can accomplish, no matter what your life circumstances are. I've always said to students, don't ever let anyone put you in a box. And although you may face challenges in your life, you got to keep it moving, okay? Because people will always try to bring you down. So watch the news clip about this inspirational teacher who passed away several years ago. And hopefully that will inspire you to watch the film and even consider a career in math and science or engineering. So enjoy the video clip, watch the movie if you get a chance, and have a great weekend. Let's go Seahorses!
We close tonight with the story of a life spent making a difference. As we told you last night, Jaime Escalante died yesterday. He was the legendary teacher immortalized in the film Stand and Deliver. He took on the students that others had given up on, tough, poor kids from East LA. He showed them how to excel and how to deliver. His story tonight from NBC's George Lewis.
To watch Jaime Escalante at Garfield High was to witness a master motivator at work. Telling inner city students you can succeed if you have the desire. In Spanish, ganas.
Ganas, the key word over here. And ganas means determination, discipline, hard work. We need students with ganas.
His students from a poor Latino crime-ridden neighborhood noted for failing schools consistently scored well in the advanced placement calculus exam. But in a controversy depicted in the movie Stand and Deliver, test administrators couldn't believe the results and accused 18 of Escalante's kids of cheating. Escalante, played by Edward James Olmos.
Those scores would have never been questioned if my kids did not have Spanish surnames and come from barrio schools, you know that.
When his students retook the test and did better the second time around, Escalante became a hero.
He's not gonna let you down. If you have the desire, if you have the ganas, he'll be there 24/7 for you.
In 1991, six of his former calculus students landed summer jobs at NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory. One of them, Thomas Valdez, is there today working on fuel cell technology.
I think Escalante actually put that spark in me that made me really want to become a scientist.
A function of, let's say, K, right?
Another Escalante student, Erica Camacho, whose parents were janitors, got a PhD in calculus and is now teaching at Arizona State University.
The impact that he had in my life and in the life of all his other students is like a domino effect. It's not gonna stop here. It's gonna go through many generations and it's gonna impact a lot of people.
And there you have the true legacy of Jaime Escalante, a whole lot of former students who overcame the odds.
He got it, you're the best.
George Lewis, NBC News, Los Angeles.
To climb and grab a hold of the edge, you were sitting there, holding a rope and we'll go up, up, up. But I'll fly a little higher, go up in the clouds because the view's a little nicer up here.